I'm Mark Wynn, Canadian taxpayer and car owner. Today, your government is going to spend billions of dollars trying to reduce auto theft. I'd like to offer a solution with your help to lay out a plan that is going to save a lot of money on insurance premiums and reduce auto theft. Today in Canada, 105,000 cars and trucks are stolen. That's in 2022. And that's a 320% plus increase from 2018. Well, what does that mean? Is that a 1 in 1,000 chance your car will be stolen? Nope. That's 1 in 228. Now keep in mind, the top 10 cars that are stolen, or the majority of cars and trucks are stolen, they're 3 years or newer. Thieves don't like to steal old cars. So if you've got a 3 year or newer car, your chances of it being stolen are about 1 in 38. I don't like those odds. With your help, I think we can offer a solution to the government and industry, that's car manufacturers, insurance companies, to let them or make them come up with a solution that doesn't cost us taxpayer dollars. Because a lot of good solutions don't need taxpayer dollars. They just need more thought. This country and most developed nations, they have motor vehicle safety standards. Ours are called CMVSS, Canadian Motor Vehicle Safety Standards. And they're laws that politicians made up. And they cover everything about a car. If you want to import your car into Canada and you're a manufacturer, you've got to comply with these laws. There's hundreds of them. And they cover everything. Where the headlights are, how big they are, how far they shine, reflection on the turn signals, little stickers you might find all over the car, the type of brake fluid that goes into it, that the car has seat belts, it has ABS, it has airbags, it has wipers, defroster, rear defroster. All these things are government regulation under CMVSS. And it's the same in the States. So they have to comply with a lot of all of those regulations if they want to sell a car in Canada. We're asking for a small change in one section, and that would be anti-theft. They haven't updated it in 20 years, so it's pathetically inadequate. It doesn't cover passive door locks. There's none of that are in the regulations. None of it. There's all kinds of other stuff, from your horn to your headlights to the tires to the windshield, what type, little certification on it, etc. But there's nothing in the regulations about auto theft. There really isn't. So we're proposing a solution that I hope you'll share with me. But a solution that the car manufacturers can implement at very minimal cost. And they have always fought this in the past. They fought seat belts. They said the cars won't sell, or it's too expensive to implement. They fought airbags. Cars won't sell, it's too expensive to implement. Whatever. They fought every single one. But they eventually all adopted it because somewhere, some country, somebody mandated it. And to sell cars, they had to keep up with their competitor, because some competitor eventually put seatbelts in a car, put airbags in a car, and they all did it. For instance, it's now law under CMVSS in Canada that car manufacturers include an ABS system. This thing cost a fortune. They put that in. Nobody's crying about that it won't sell a car or it's too expensive. But that thing cost a lot of money, oftentimes thousands. So what we're asking for is a very inexpensive small change in regulation and in the modification of the car. So I can't see how anybody's going to lose over this. Certainly there'll be no taxpayer expense. We won't have to increase border security. In fact, we might be able to decrease it. We won't have to increase policing. In fact, maybe if auto theft goes down, we can decrease that. Not suggesting that, but I mean, at least it won't have to have an increase. All that's taxpayer dollars. And if you do all those proposed changes of increasing border security to fight auto theft and increasing policing and increasing jailing people and all those other things, it's going to be billions to the taxpayer. I prefer the cheaper solution. just change a little law and implement a small change on the part of the manufacturers, and everybody should be happy. So let's see what the little change is that we're proposing. The solution. See this? It's my tablet. Turn it on. Screen's locked. What do I got? A pin pad. A user, selectable. Password. Here's my computer. Guess we're all used to that. What does that have? It has a user, selectable. Password. And of course, we're all used to these things. They have some kind of password protection on it, either a pin or some kind of diagram that you've got to do. That's how you get into these things. Not a car, though. You see that? That's a pin pad on the outside of a Ford on its door, where you have a user selectable pin that you have to put in. Now, that particular system has been in use since the late 80s, 90s for sure, still in use today, but it only gets you in the car. It doesn't stop the car from being stolen. They can still use a relay attack with the key, but it shows that they do have a user selectable pin pad, doesn't it? So that kind of proves that they've got the technology to do it, and they've actually put it on the car. It's just that they just limited it to the door. So, what do the manufacturers have to do? It actually comes down to a software change. No expensive stuff like that ABS or seat belts or airbags. None of that. Just a software change. Right here, you've got the screen, touch screen, like most cars have today. Right? And if you look around, there's your keyboard. So it already has a keyboard on the car that you can use to put in numbers, put in letters, that kind of thing. So this can be used to input your own personal PIN. There's a reason that Teslas are really, very few of them are ever stolen. Because you can put your own personalized PIN in a Tesla. Most people don't know that. But Teslas, they've also got a lot of cameras on them. And they could also use the camera on the rear view camera on a car to take a picture of the criminal if they wanted to do that or mandate that, but just give us a usable user interface to put in a password. That's all they've got to do. Now, currently, the car's computer system runs on a thing called a CAN bus, and all you have to do with that, again, software change, put in a gateway that controls that network that is only activated with this password. That'll stop all those people trying to do a CAN bus sniff, it's called, where they disconnect the headlight or something like that, and they gain access to the car's computer system. Well, if the car's computer system has a user-settable lock, there'll be millions of cars with millions of different passwords on them that, will completely stop it, just like your phone. Like, how many people steal an iPhone and get into it? Nobody. And the FBI has a tough time getting into it. So can't we at least have the same amount of security on our cars as we do on a tablet or phone or a computer? It seems ridiculous. And I'm just proving here, the car has the equipment. It's got a screen. It's a touch screen. We can input numbers and letters into it. And it goes, of course, all this information goes through the CAN bus system in the car. It has to. I mean, they already... the car manufacturers already restrict and lock up the CAN bus, but you know who they lock out? Mechanics. They try to service your car and put in a scan tool, and it comes up against a security code that they have to pay for to in order to scan your car and fix it. That's what it's coming to. They already lock it up. So we're not even asking for a bigger change or a very expensive change. Just lock up the main car and let the customer do it. Let them lock up the computer, because there'll be no using a CAN bus system then to hack your car. And all these kids depend on the CAN bus system. They've got all the tools for it. They're cheap.
You can get them on eBay. You can get them on Amazon. And that's why it has exploded, because it's really simple to hack into a car's system using these tools. But there isn't going to be a tool for cracking a PIN code, because they'd all be different, wouldn't they? That's like somebody having a cheap tool on eBay that cracks an iPhone. No, there is no such thing. And as far as we can see into the future, we've had that CAN bus system, computer system, type computer network, since the 90s. It's here to stay. So you need to protect that system, and it has to be a user PIN code or user code. That will stop it. Now, there's one more thing that needs to do, that you need to do, as well as this. There is a small hardware change, but it's not expensive.
Now, the CAN bus lock on its gateway, if you put a gateway on there, and it has a makes you put in a PIN once you're in the car, that will stop the car from being stolen. But people like that keyless entry feature. So how do you stop them from getting in the car? Because obviously you got to be in the car before you put the password in, unless there's an app or something, of course. And some car manufacturers already do this, by the way. They're already using. Tesla comes to mind. So again, it can be done. It's already being done by a leading manufacturer. So, you know, all the complaints or excuses or it can't be done or it's really expensive or nobody will buy the car. Nonsense. They're doing it already. The other thing they might want to do is on the back of the car's remote, the passive one that everybody has to buy a Faraday bag for and hide the key and all this stuff. All they have to do is this. Same thing they have on your mouse. Just put a switch, a very cheap one, on the back. That turns it off. It's mechanical. Nothing. You can't bypass that electronically. The mouse is dead. Doesn't work at all. Because it's battery operated, this kills the battery, this switch. So, what do you do with your remote? Just put a little off-on switch on the back of the remote. That's it, it kills it. So a relay attack, a kid comes up with a, you know, with their cheap bypass stuff where they're gonna do a relay attack, it won't work. It's not gonna pick up anything. The remote's dead, there's nothing to pick up. If you've got that turned off, just a simple switch. So a simple switch, and a software change that locks up the car's computer system, the CAN bus. Technically, putting in a gateway with a user selectable code is not expensive, involves no taxpayer dollars, and it could be done very quickly. As I say, some companies like Tesla already have the PIN, and perhaps Rolls-Royce, you can get an app with a pin on it, that kind of thing. That stops them cold. They can't stick something, you know, take off a connection to your headlight and put a few wires into it and corrupt the CAN bus system and pop the car open. No, it'll be locked by the owner with a personal pin, just like your phone, just like a tablet. Okay? People are saying today's cars are like phones. Yeah, almost, not quite. The security on this phone is a lot better than the security on every car imported into this country. So I need your help to share this video to give the politicians and the lawmakers a very simple, effective, cheap, and straightforward way to protect a car from these types of theft that are occurring today, which is these cheap electronic hacking devices. This stuff will stop them cold. Absolutely. And it won't cost us, the taxpayer, anything. So what this is a video petition. It's different than the regular kind. It has its advantages. What I'm asking you to do to help lower taxes and to reduce auto theft and insurance premiums is to take this video and share it on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, X. Send it to politicians like the Prime Minister of Canada, the official opposition leader, transportation minister, any politician, a local one to you, it's a federal politician. asking them to change the law for the benefit of everybody, for lower insurance rates, less auto theft, etc. Now, the benefit to this video petition is that they'll have to watch the whole video as opposed to just seeing a piece of paper with thousands of signatures on it. They'll see how many view counts it gets. They'll see how popular it is. Yeah, hopefully it is. And best of all, you get to leave a comment. Can't do that on a regular petition. So below the video, you have a few words of wisdom or suggestions yourself for the appropriate official, whether that be a politician or a bureaucrat of some kind. Feel free to leave it. Now, keep the comments civil. Any offensive comments will be removed. But otherwise, let rip. Anyway, I hope you can do this. It's a public service if you do. It will make society better, and it will work. So please share this video as much as you can. And please remember, leave a comment if you want. And hopefully this changes things. Cheers from Canada. Thanks.